Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Subnautica. Today, we are going to... I'm actually going to hit tab, pull up the Subnautica map. We're going to go spelunking. We're going to look for wreckages and see if we can... I think this is the map I want right here. Yeah. Okay, so this the map that I just pulled up gives me locations of some wreckages, and it tells me which leviathans are and predators are in which zones, which is really helpful. So we are going to put away some of the stuff that we've got in our bags here. I don't have space. I want that with me. Don't need this. How much titanium do I have? Because I think I'm going to have to empty out. Oh, let's make some water. That's a good idea. Good thinking. car. That's cool. Okay, let's pull out our habitat builder and put these back where they belong. Did not work. There we go. No, that didn't even work. Come on. Put it there. There we go. Okay. I'm going to make some more wall storage. And we're just going to put them here. And we're going to put the rest of this stuff in there that we don't need. I'll take all this with me just in case I get into a sticky situation. Shouldn't need the radiation helmet, but I'll take it anyway. If we have extra full batteries, I will take those. We should have a lot from our trip over to the what's it called? The Aurora. Let's take three batteries. That should be plenty. We'll have four things of water. And while we're here, let's see if we can put this upgrade, this depth upgrade on the Seamoth. I don't think we'll be able to put upgrades on the Seamoth, but I think we're going to need a modification station to do that. Let's see. Modifications are over here. Oh, we do. We access upgrades. There we go. Okay, so now I have... I am stupid. Don't right-click stuff. Left-click. There we go. Okay, so now I can go 300 meters with my Seamoth, and if I come over here, I've got a storage. So I can stick things like batteries in here, all but one of my food. I can put a bunch of water in there. So let's go get some coral, tube coral here for the salt that I have, and make some water. Okay. I hope you guys are having fun watching this. I'm having fun playing it. I know what's ahead of us though, so so I'm really excited. You, on the other hand, you don't.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Is this growing? Do I have seeds in here? No. Let's get this growing. And it looks like I need to do one more. Okay. And we'll top off our health while we're at it. There we go. Okay, cool. Alright, so, over here and make some water. And then we're gonna go look for some wreckages and see if I can't get myself drowned. this map that I pulled up, if you want the map, just search for Subnautica map, and the map that shows up is on the Subnautica wiki. Anyway, it's got all the different... It's got the map. It's got the Aurora on the side. And then on the right side of all of that, it's got, like, the hostile creatures and which zone they're in by color. Where to find different, different pieces. There's a couple maps that I like. So when you Google Subnautica map, it's the... first and second one that I like the best. Both of those are really good. So you're gonna probably see this come across the screen, maybe. Nope, sweet. So I'm gonna have them, both of them up, just so that I can have, just so that I can have access to some information on one and not the other. You know, so anyway, you know what I'm trying to say. Like, there's information on one that isn't on the other, and so I'll have them both up. All right, let's head. Where are we? We're at zero. So if you look on the map, we're at zero. So directly north of us, this escape pod here is zero. So if we go directly north, there should be a wreckage. And that's where we'll start. It's a little bit northeast, just a touch. And it should be in the safe shallows before you get to the kelp forest. So it should be right around here. So we're surrounded by kelp forest. Maybe it's over to the right a little bit. Should be right here. Okay, so this little peninsula here is still part of the safe shallows. On either side is the kelp forest, so it should be right around here somewhere. And there it is. Sweet. Okay, I think this is a very minor one. This is one you're supposed to find early, so this should have hardly anything in it. There's the sea glide fragment, and then there should be a bunch of, like, salvage and stuff that you can get from here. But other than that, I think this is one of the very more mild ones that you get. I don't think that that's a... I'm gonna hop out anyway. I don't think that this is part of the Cyclops. I don't think they'd give you that information so early. Okay, the next one I'm gonna look for is southeast of zero. I'm gonna take care of all of the ones in the shallows first, and then I'll go out from there. So let's head back to zero. And this is just going to be a map of exploration. And then we're going to head almost exactly southwest. There should be another one. And it's right in the blood kelp forest. Not blood kelp forest, the grassy plateaus. Okay, so here's zero. We're gonna head southwest. Southwest? Right? Yeah, okay, so we're gonna go through... Actually, this shouldn't be going through... Oh, I see. Zero is not exactly at the pod. Okay. So we're gonna go back to the pod here. I don't know why they would make coordinate systems like that. Where is it? There it is. Okay, and then we're gonna head, now that I know where the pod is, I'm gonna head kind of, that was gross. Southeast, just a little bit, or southwest still, but more west than south. Okay, so more west than south. Let's head this direction. We're going to go through... we should come out on the other side of here. We should come in to... Come up to... I think we've been to this one before. We should head... we should run into... Yes. The grassy plateau. And then the wreckage should be right... I don't think that's considered the wreckage. Right over here, maybe. Maybe it was more west than anything. Basically, we're looking for an alcove of where the grassy plateaus is. And then it should be surrounded by safe shallows. Yeah. Now, this is the other direction. Okay, so we're gonna head back. I wish there was coordinates in the game, because then you could just use the coordinates on the map and find what you need there. I think it's this way. But I think we've been to this one before. Oh man, big guy got stuck in the in the ground there. Careful, man, and get yourself hurt. Okay, yeah, here we go. And I have been to this. Let's just make sure that we haven't missed anything. Like, what? I think that's just a repair tool. And yeah, we've scouted everything here. Okay, next is directly east of this, so we'll just head directly east. We should run right into it. There should be two this direction, so that's a good thing. And they're both in the safe, technically in the safe shallows. Yeah, here's one. And I think we've been to this one quite a few times. Nothing of interest in here. And the next one, this is where we get the grav traps and stuff. The next one should be right over the hill, just past this place. Be this direction just a little bit. So we're back in the safe shallows, and we need to... We're gonna be heading towards the Aurora? No. Okay, so it'd be this direction here. Okay. Should be right next to the tail end of the ship. Yeah, here it is. And I don't think I've been here, so let me hop out and see what I can find in here. Oh, there's a little forklift that came out. Altira, what is this? Is that a trash can or something? It's a fancy looking trash can. Grav trap we've got. Another sea glide. So you can see there's a bunch of different locations to get the sea glide. You don't have to necessarily get it where I got it, but... Okay, so I'm assuming there's not going to be a lot that we can learn from. Hey, what is that? Sample analyzer. Cool. So you don't have to get that from the Aurora. Remember that was in the lab in the Aurora? It doesn't necessarily have to get it from there. Okay, I think that's all of them from the safe shallows. Let's take a look at the ones in the kelp forest and the grassy plateaus. This will be most of them. Outside of that, there's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 that are considered in super dangerous zone. 8 that are considered in super dangerous zones. We will go explore them all because we need to find everything that's in them. So there should be one directly south of us in the kelp forest. Is this, are we right by the Aurora? Am I where we think we are? Yeah. Okay, so directly south of us. And we should run into the kelp forest here, like I said. And then... This looks like grassy plateau. And there isn't anything in there. There should be something... Oh, there's another one. Okay, let's head back north. There's another one in the safe shallows that I didn't see. A third one. Okay. Where did that wreckage go? I'm not quite there yet, am I? Yeah, right here. Okay. There should be another one more east. More towards the ship. Yeah, okay. Okay, and it should be in the safe shallows. And this should be directly south of life pod... 5? No, it doesn't say the numbers. There should be a lifeboat over here, though. There's a little bit northeast, for sure. Just a little bit. We run into the Aurora, which we are. We have gone too far. Okay, so it's around here somewhere. There it is. Okay, now this is one that I don't think that I have explored either, so I'm gonna hop out and see what I can find. Nothing in there. Okay. Like I said, these are safe shallows. These aren't gonna have anything monumental in them, I don't believe. And we might get lucky, but I really need to make a see, there's another beacon. I think that's something that I need, actually. I don't think that I have all of the beacon fragments. Awesome. So now, I can stick beacons kind of anywhere I want them. The recipe for those is relatively cheap, I believe. Here we go. So yeah, copper and titanium. That's super cheap. So I can put the beacon like on each base and label them, right? And I'm gonna need help coming up with names for bases for sure. So it is useful to go around to these different areas. I mean, if anything, these are, right, these are, once you scan them, they're good for titanium. Okay, that should be all. Now there should be one directly south of us. And we should run into a kelp forest. If we go directly south. This will be even closer to the Aurora, which is terrifying. We should run into a kelp forest over here. If we don't, want to be careful. There's a there is a known Leviathan in the area. Yep. He's gonna eat me. If you just crap your pants like I did. Yeah. Yep. That's the sound of him coming after you. Alright. Okay, here's the kelp forest we were looking for. Oh my goodness. Okay. Yep. Alright. So, let's compose ourselves here. Repair our sea moth from being almost eaten. I hope that the fear that I felt that, like, put chills in my entire body, you felt as well. Because, oh my goodness. Okay, I have no idea where we are. But yeah, so don't go directly south of that. You will get eaten. Okay, so where are we? Let's come to the surface and see. Thank goodness. Okay, yeah, don't go any more east of this right here. So this is the Blood Kelp Forest that we were looking, or the kelp forest we were looking for. This is a relatively small biome. It's surrounded by the terror that is to the east of us, and shallows, and so like this is considered the safe shallows here. So if I enter in here and go to the middle of it, we should see it. I mean, it's right in the middle, a little bit on the west side. So we've gone too far. And the predators, those leviathans, won't come into these other biomes. So if you're near a biome, get into it. They won't follow you in normally. Okay. That should be. I don't think that's it. I think that's considered part of the Aurora. It should be right around here somewhere. Is it down more? But yeah, if you hear that sound, there's no getting away from that. Like, you're getting eaten. So, the sound being, like, if you rewind it back and me turning and running, that's the sound of him, like, he's right there. He's going to eat you. And it's the scariest part is when you hear that, but you have no idea where he is. You could be swimming, you could be driving right into him. I couldn't see where I was going. It's too dark down there, so I didn't want to turn off my lights, but knowing, I knew that if you see him and you turn off your lights and stop moving, it's likely that he won't come after you like we did in the other episode, right? I haven't found it. Where is it? It should be here somewhere. But anyway, if you see him and he's off in the distance, turn off your lights. I think I have this already. Yeah. Turn off your lights and stop moving. And he generally will leave you alone. But once you hear that sound, like he's in your ear, he's swimming at you, and you cannot get away from him. There is no getting away from him. Alright, so this, according to this, is on the west side, which is where we are. And maybe it's down here. No. Okay, this is a beautiful biome. I love the kelp forests. I think they're my favorite. It's just so... I feel like I'm in a fish aquarium. And I'm the little fish swimming around the little caves. Oh, that's something. Let's go get that. Engine fragment from the Cyclops. Yes, siree. Okay.
New blueprint acquired.
If I go to the surface, I believe the... Oh. I'm completely turned around. Okay, there we go. So, we need to go on that side of it and search for the wreckage. Maybe that's it? I don't know. That was just in a random spot. But anyway, now you know where that is. Here is something else. That's probably water or something. Battery. Sweet. Put that in our storage here. No, we'll keep the battery on us. If I'm swimming away from something and my battery dies, I'd like to be able to replace it rather quickly. Okay, now there should be a wreckage, like, right around here somewhere. I don't see anything that would be significant enough. I mean, that's just salvage, right? Maybe I'll make a couple episodes out of this where we go around to the different crash sites. I mean, unless that's it, and my goodness, I'm very hesitant to come over here. This is not in the kelp forest, by the way. This is in scary zone? Oh my goodness. If he gets a hold of me and I'm not in my suit. I don't think I need this. Great. Oh my gosh! okay. That was terrifying. He swam right over top of me. Okay, well that's definitely a crash site. Right there. I need to get over there, Mr. Leviathan. Would you leave me alone, please? Nope, he's just gonna stay in the area because he knows there's food here. Oh my goodness. That's why I love this game. So there's this thing, there's a difference between terror and fear and horror. Oh my goodness, he's coming in. He's not supposed to come in. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm done with that. That wreckage can just go jump in a lake. Like, I'm done. I'm done being scared. We'll come back another day when he's decided to swim off towards the nose or something. He does not want me getting into that. Oh, you know what? I'll bet the lights are attracting him. I'll bet if we turn off the lights. He might go away. Either way, I'm done with this salvage. We're going to head directly north of us and try and stop shaking. Yeah. Goodness gracious. Yeah, so I was going to say that there's a difference between terror and horror. Horror is things like zombies and they've got like a one-time, you know, oh, it's a startle effect, or, you know, you've got this, have you ever seen The Exorcist, and you've got that, the girl who's vomiting and spinning her head, and the first time you see that, you're like, that's scary, I never want to see that again. But terror is, I think, is defined by knowing that something can hurt you, or that will, that could eventually hurt you. It's like the unknown. I think we've been to this before as well, but let's hop out here. There's far less scary things in this water than that. That's the more in interaction with the Leviathan than the Reaper Leviathan than I ever have experienced before. And I can't say that I've actually ever, you know, shouted out in fear like that before playing this game. It was right over my head. Ah!
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay, now directly northwest of us, if I keep going north, straight north, I should run into a kelp forest. Right? Okay, what in the world? Is this accurate? Because... where even am I? Are these north and south not even correct on this map? Okay, the Aurora should be to behind me to my right. It is, okay. Maybe they don't consider that a wreckage. Because here's a pod, right? And I don't see this pod listed on the map. But this is one that we have been to. Did I miss that PDA sitting on the ground there? Oh, I have not been here. You get out of here. I want this PDA. Okay, this is life pod. Oh, I have been here.
New PDA data.
Some flares. I don't need the flares. I just never grabbed the PDA data from this. Yeah, once you encounter Leviathan, these guys are not scary at all. ancient flower. This is something I scanned the other day. Let's listen to this Aurora survivor. This is crew pod 6. Interesting.
Ma'am, I need you to stay calm. We're not in immediate danger.
Where are the rescue teams?
The Aurora didn't make it.
So where are the rescue teams?
They're dead, ma'am. We have rendezvous coordinates, but the routes are radiated.
So, what are you going to do?
I'm head of human resources, ma'am. This is not my expertise. But the PDA says if we can find some lead, we can make radiation suits.
Oh, there! I am not setting foot outside this life pod without the proper protection.
Don't worry. I'll go.
Aw. Whoa! Hey! Okay, so I think this is the one that... I just swam right past this. So my video card should be getting here tomorrow. I ended up having to order it online because, I don't know. Best Buy had one that was $100 more, and I didn't feel like paying $100 more for the same video card. Oh, ouch. Those guys, by the way, those guys will spit spikes at you, and they hurt. Is he guarding? Is he guarding something valuable? No, it doesn't look like it. These guys right here. So if you swim up to them, close enough to them, they'll shoot it, spit at you. Like, he should shoot something at me here. Or does he not see? Interesting. He doesn't attack boats. Okay, vehicles. How do I get into this? This is what we have mainly wanted to do today. So let's turn our lights back on. We'll go... yeah, I know we're low on water and food, so So let's open this. Alright. Ooh, scary music. Nothing in here. Yeah, really scary music. What in the world? Maybe it's just creepy because it's a crash site or something. But I'm looking for... looking for moon pool information. Some water. Propulsion. I think we have the propulsion. Propulsion cannon. Yeah. Ooh. Cool. Okay, we're gonna have to get some more oxygen before we go down there. I've been kind of slow coming through here. Nothing else in here? There's a door here, but I don't think I can open it. It's all shut. So let's head... Ooh, that's cool. Natural selection poster. That's sweet! Look at that! Okay. I think there was something here, and I think I did get whatever was in here. I just, yeah. Let's get some more oxygen. Let's load up on water and food. So we'll refill our food, drink some water here. Oh man, I'm out of water already. We'll put some of this in our storage, like the natural selection poster, and then we'll head back in. Water. Okay. And I think I might have come in here already. Like, there might be a way up here. Oh, nice. Nope, I have not. Okay, some more water. Sweet. This is a propulsion cannon. We've got that all taken care of. Is there anything else in here that would be of use? No, it's all propulsion cannon. Propulsion cannon is really neat because it can take like smaller fish and launch them away from you, which is pretty cool. Like those guys that on the Aurora that were scuttling around, like the little crabs, like they were really annoying, and you could just take them and launch them up into space. yeah. And that's really, really handy. Okay, so let's head down here. Let's see where this takes us. This takes us outside. Okay. Cool. Alright, we're done with this one. That's everything in there. That's a pretty sizable find. And, alright, so now let's head up, and we're going to go directly west. This should take us to life pod and... So this should take us into the kelp forest, which it usually does. The safe shallows is usually surrounded by the kelp forest. This should take us to a crash site. I think this might be it right here. Yeah. Okay, we definitely have not explored this one yet. Where's the entrance here? Right there. Let's put the lights on here and then head down and come in. So yeah, we're looking for the moon pool base, moon pool fragments, anything to do with the Cyclops. And then I think modification station is another one we're looking for. So let's head up and take a look at what we have. So if we open your PDA and come into blueprints, as soon as you scan something, it'll tell you what you're looking for. So looking for two more of the bridge, two more of the hull, and then I think that will give you the entire Cyclops stuff. Over here we need one more moon pool, and nuclear reactor would be really neat. Alien containment would be really neat. Power cell charger. Oh, we do have the modification station done. Okay, cool. So we're just looking for basically Moonpool and Cyclops stuff. Let's see what's in here. So here's a PDA we can listen to. Let's listen to that while we're digging around.
Integrating new PDA data.
Where is that? Maybe that was some data that we already knew or something? I don't know. It says new PDA data though, so what is this? Mobile vehicle bay fragment, and that's it in here. Okay, I'm gonna go do my air, and then we'll just go a little deeper. And that makes me a little sad. It's like it opened up to it, and then I clicked away from it or something, and I shouldn't have. Okay, so this goes outside. So what's the point in cutting our way in here if we can just get in here from the outside? Does this actually lead anywhere? No? Is that it? Is that literally all that it is? Okay. On to the next one.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
The next one should be directly west of us in another, a little bit southwest, but pretty west. So we should pass through either Safe Shallows, Mossy Plateau, and then into another kelp forest, and that's kind of what we're looking for here. So here is the Safe Shallows, Mossy Plateau, back into the Safe Shallows, and into... Sweet. We're heading the right direction. And we should see one here directly south of the of a grassy plateau's biome. It should be over there. We should see it fairly easy. This is not something that I did, but the first time I played through this, I kind of wanted to see if I could find all of them myself. I didn't actually go around and have a map open. It's kind of far in, but perhaps I should come in a little bit and then negative. Okay, so I think this is the end. Over here should be Safe Shallows, and over here should be the Mossy Plateau, right? Yeah, it's definitely not here. Okay, so let's head back into here, and we'll kind of head a little bit, actually let's follow the edge here, so it should be pretty close to the... Oh, what is that? Okay, so that's where we're at. That is the mushroom forest. There's something there as well. Whoa.
What are you?
What was that? That was creepy. Okay, so... There's something that can talk to me telepathically, and depending on her intentions, could be psychopathically as well. Okay, so it should be right around here somewhere. So if we follow, okay, so this is going to curve a little bit. Should be right. Where is it? Yeah, we missed it. Okay, so it should be... It's in here somewhere. We'll just go back and forth until we find it. There is something. I think that's a mobile vehicle bay. Wow, that's so pretty. Seriously, that is really cool. Safe shallows again. There's another something there. What is that? I think that's a sea glide. Yeah. Okay. Wrong direction. So I want to go east and west is what I kind of want to do. But southeast. Where am I? let's get our bearings. So let's head back west. We will find this. So this should be the mushroom forest here, right? Okay. Now, where the mushroom forest meets the grassy plateau and the kelp forest, from here it is, I mean, it's east, it's mostly east, but a little bit southeast. So it should be, we'll try doing it this way. This is kind of fun, treasure hunting. Here it is. Okay, I think we've been to this one before. I'm almost 100% certain we have. I'll hop out here. Yeah. Yeah, we've collected that information. Oh. Hey, let's repair this door. We missed that last time we were here. It's a good thing I decided to come in after all. Okay. Open this up. And yes, more treats. Okay, so we've got the mobile vehicle bay done. What is stasis rifle? We got all that. I think so. Yeah. Mobile vehicle bay. Yeah. Yeah, we've gotten everything in here. This is just to give us the mobile vehicle bay, basically. So let's get out of here, and we'll head to. I know that time is pretty much 40 minutes. Maybe I'll break this up into two parts.